TV starts now!
Good morning, Marauders. My name's Nathan.
And I'm Nathan.
Welcome back to another episode of MTV.
You know that Miss Margosian has a story for you?
I'd love to hear it. Let's go to a video made by Juan and Brayden.
Hi, Marauders. My name is Bailey Margosian, and I am an English teacher here at Menachi. This is my second year teaching here at Menachi, but I did attend here back in 2015, and I played basketball here and golf, and now I am the girls' golf coach. So some things about me is I went to Fresno State right out of high school, and I majored in media communications and journalism. I was at Fresno State. I worked at the Collegian, which is the school newspaper, and I did sales for them. I was the general sales manager for a couple years. I also did a lot of internships, which I highly recommend seniors if you're looking into colleges. If I could give you some advice, it's go out and get those internships because it's great exposure to the real work world. I interned with the Central California Women's Conference for 2 years. So they put on this big event and I just helped them with their social media marketing. And I also was an intern for the Central California Blood Center. So with the blood drives that we have here on campus, I helped them with their advertising. I worked at JP Marketing when I lived in Fresno. I did that for about a year, and then I realized my passion was with teaching. So I kind of just went back to school, got my credential, and now here I am. That's about it for my spotlight. I know my story is kind of short. I'm still writing it, but hope you enjoyed.
Truly remarkable.
Amen, brother. Now let's go to the weather with Nathan.
Hey Marauders, this week will have a high of 81 and a low of 55. It will also be raining on Thursday and Friday. Stay safe, Marauders.
Wow, that's hot. Very much so. You know, I always wondered what circumstances led to the founding of the town, Portola, California. You know what? Lucky for you, Isabel Amber made a video about that very topic. Let's go on to the video.
My name is Susan Uptain, and I'm the treasurer here at the Porterville Historical Museum. When you enter the museum, the first room that you will come to is the history of the Yokut Native Americans that were here in the valley. You'll get to see the basketry that they made and all the different things that they made and constructed to live and work and be able to exist. Very fascinating culture. Once you have seen that, then you'll come around into this hallway, and this is the Porter Putnam hallway. A man named Peter Goodhue originally purchased the land, and it was called the Goodhue Crossing in 1858. Porter Putnam came from back east. To get anywhere in this valley, he had to be a merchant or run cattle or, you know, something of this nature. So what he did in 1863 is he purchased the original acreage for Porterville from Peter Goodhue. But in 1870, he thought, okay, I'm going to get serious. I'm going to get a town here. So he started giving away lots to anybody who would build a business, build a house. In 1888, he actually got successful enough that he was able to build his own home here, because originally he would just live above the store. He had a mercantile store, which actually did quite well, and he wanted trees at his house, so he was really wanted this lemon tree there, so he dug up a lemon tree and he moved it. It was raining. He got sick, caught pneumonia, passes away. He's only 52. But he did have two children, Frank and Samuel, and they decided that they would carry on their father's legacy. And his wife, Mary, continued to live in the house on Putnam Street, and she was known as the Queen of Porterville. The other thing that's really important to this town was citrus. And in the 1880s to the 1920s is when citrus really took hold here. In the museum, in the baggage room in the museum, we have an entire display about citrus, and it's got citrus labels in it, and they also had citrus fairs, and they made these huge, out of oranges, these huge structures. So the town was really started in 1861, and in 1961 was 100 years. And we had a huge centennial celebration here. People dressed up in period clothing. That's when the Jackass Mail Run got started. It was just a whole year of just total fun and activity. Porter Putnam established Porterville, and it has just basically grown from there. I mean, when he passed, there were probably 250 people here. I came here in about 1965. I think there were 12,000 people here in 1965. Just not, it's still a pretty small town. And then today, there's over 60,000 people living here. So it has come a long way. She'll brush away
a tear as Deb says, look who's... So cool and awesome. For real. Anyways, you'll never guess who the host for sports will be.
Good morning, Marauders. On Wednesday, we're having track boys and girls varsity against Golden West, baseball freshman JV varsity against Redwood, and on Thursday, tennis boys JV varsity against El Diamante. Good luck, Marauders.
Man, we're geeking in sports. Indeed we are. Well, I'm Nathan.
And I'm Nathan.
Sure to like and subscribe, and we're signing off. A little ink between my shoulder and my jaw. Pour out a drink and sip it through a plastic straw. Sink all my teeth into a million-dollar mold. And have my name spelled out in gold. Or could I stand to maybe show a little skin? Tear all my clothes and patch them up with safety pins. Nobody warned me we get sick of centerfolds. I'm getting bored or getting old. So why don't feed you my heart well enough that I don't need any part of your love? Then tell someone what you wish I would have done. Make me bleed if you need to come back. Hey Marauders, these are this week's sports wins. Baseball against Wasco, 3-0. 10-6 and 1 overall, 1-3 in league. Good luck, Marauders. The day before they formally announced me dead.